Chill.
Nothing but real nigga conversation. Without explanation. Kissing babies and shaking hands, man.
Chill.
Out here doing. You hear me? What the fuck I got to do out here to make it black, open, and you are now experiencing
world famous
Boss Mac Podcast, RNS, y'all are in motherfucking ass. Oh yes, today is a beautiful day. I'm happy as fuck to be up in there doing this. Y'all niggas already know how I get down. Nothing but good game when I come around. Balls, Mac, topsoil, y'all got to love the sound. And today, I got a special guest in this motherfucker with me. My people's boogaloo is in this motherfucker with me. One night, one time. And my nigga, Mari Ruger, is in this motherfucker with the Boss Mac topsoil tonight.
What's up
with you, my nigga?
Oh, what's up?
Man, it's a beautiful situation, man.
Yeah, it is.
Hey, man, you know, happy to see you. Happy to have you in here, Boogaloo, you know.
Feel good to be here, man.
Man,
feel good to be home, man.
Man.
It's my home right here.
Got a nigga sweating up a storm like a motherfucker, man. Where my motherfucker up?
Sorry, we gonna get it together. We'll get it together.
Alright.
That's the lights in this motherfucker.
Nigga sweating like a motherfucker.
This shit like a photo shoot, man.
Shit, man. Like I said, man, I'm feeling good like you know I should. I got my peoples in this motherfucker.
Yes, sir.
Y'all know how we get down. We always come with the bomb agenda for you, you know.
Talk about it.
We come with the sponsors, niggas in the news, reader, listener, emails, and whatnot. And today, we got the young homie in this motherfucker, one of the up and comings, one of the movers and the shakers off the soil. Young Mari Ruger in this motherfucker, man. And so y'all will be blessed. Hey, like I said, the show is brought to you by Boss Mac Streetwear. You see, I got on some Boss Mac Streetwear right now. This is like some you know, just the OG logo, simplistic type shit.
What's that? That forest green?
Yeah, that forest green. You know, with the red.
Cherry on there.
Yeah, I felt like it just popped. You know what I'm saying? Go with the hat. You feel me? You can put something together, man, and get.
Oh, that's the Boss Mac hat you got.
Yeah, that's the bucket, bro. Like, you know, we got the buckets on deck.
I see you.
You know, I'm a fisherman. You know, taking it back to the. Back in the 80s, bringing it up to now, but it's modern now, though, still.
Definitely. Bucket fly.
Yeah, it is. So, you know, we just trying to bless y'all, man. Fuck with us, don't fuck with them. You know what I mean? And you know, we got the offensive shit that you see the Snoop Dogg wearing, and you see the beanie.
Everybody love the bitch relax shit.
Everybody love the bitch relax.
Look, my girlfriend kids was trying to wear one of the shirts to school.
Just trying to get it from me.
Yeah, just trying to steal my shit, though. I feel good about that.
And my girl,
you can't wear no bitch relax shit to those school. You'll get a call before you get the first period.
Hey, man. So you walk on campus.
Yeah. The other one talking about, well, I want to wear it to my job. No.
That's what I'm talking about.
Hey, but yeah, every time I wear that bitch relax, though, I'll be walking past somewhere, bitch relax, or somebody say that shit, and I forget that I'm wearing the shirt and be looking at them halfway and talk, oh, yeah, the shirt.
Hey, I got to give me one of them bitch relax.
Yeah,
oh, I got you tonight. I got some shit over there for you, buddy.
Yeah, that's classic,
video attire. You know, I kicked that dog talk. That's real.
Yeah.
Bitch relax.
Yeah. Yeah. I appreciate that, man. I appreciate that feedback. Made my night like a motherfucker, man. Yeah, and also if you need some game because you're struggling with your bitch out there,
get at us.
Jump in the descriptions, tap in, holla at the boss back, man, and you know, I bless you and take care of your man.
Mm-hmm. We save relationships. We help you out when you're down and out and you're going through. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man.
Shoot that
look
email
out for a little bit.
Yeah, we got you.
Yeah, man. I'm going to take care of you, man. Holla at me, man, with the reasonable rates, man. And they ain't going to stay low long because you know it's inflationary times, man. I'm trying to look out for niggas, man. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I wish I had a nigga to call and get some game from when I was struggling back in the days.
Right.
As a young nigga out there with... with bitches, you know what I'm saying, and they got they sisters and they aunts using them against me and shit.
Mm-hmm. Whole household.
You know what I'm saying? Everybody, I'm just one little nigga. Right. Ain't nobody giving me no game. I don't know what to say. Fuck with me though. Boogaloo, how you been doing, nigga?
I'm good, boss man. You know I'm good, man.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm feeling good.
Yeah, man.
Looking good.
Yeah, man. Look at that. I see niggas out there, man. I see
niggas. Oh, man. Always happy to be home, man. Always. You know, I started off with you.
Yeah, man.
I did all type of shit, but I started off right
bro,
here.
Bro, I be, you know what? You be, you know what? I was just randomly going through some shit, and I just seen you on some shit, bro.
Are you seeing me on some shit?
I just be like, man, this nigga be on shit and don't say shit about it. This nigga just be on some shit and be like, fuck it, I was on there.
Solid accomplishment.
It's over now.
Yeah, just put it in the world.
Yeah, man.
Content.
I was looking at some Skip Towns and shit. I was like, man, this shit was recently.
Yeah, it was.
This nigga ain't even.
It was. Do you know, that's crazy that you said that, right? I had about 5 or 6 people come up to me like, hey man, I like that interview with you and Skip, right?
Whoa. Bro.
And I have never seen it myself. So yesterday, I hit up Skip like, man, niggas keep asking me about the interview.
Nigga.
You never even sent it to me. Like, send me the interview. And last night, I sat up and watched that shit, the whole shit.
Boogaloo, I gotta ask you, my nigga.
What's up, G?
You don't never just put Boogaloo into YouTube and see what the fuck come up, nigga?
Yeah, I have.
You have?
Yeah,
you don't
I
do
have.
That like every day and
I
type
don't,
shit?
I don't, no.
To
don't.
See the change, the new shit?
I don't. It just seemed like I don't know. I do some shit, then I'm off to the next shit. I do it, then I'm off to the next shit.
I feel you.
I'm trying to get better and better.
I feel you.
Better,
I feel you, my nigga. I feel you, my nigga. I feel you. I'm
just
like, this nigga
up.
Got content like a motherfucker.
Just so focused on what's next. You know what I mean?
Man, your shit come up with Munchie B shit.
Oh, yeah.
No, it's Munchie B, and it's your shit.
Munchie B, my nigga, too.
And I'm like, what the fuck is this, right? I'm like, this nigga ain't even told me about it. Like,
I even pulled up some shit on YouTube and put my name in like a little minute ago. And that day you came to the park.
Oh yeah.
And filmed the shit that popped up too.
You ain't never looked at that?
Yeah, I looked at that too. That was a good interview.
That was low
key. That was a cool little thing. You
that's
like
low key viral.
Yeah, it is. It is. It is.
You see that Ruger? Look how this nigga is, bro. Bro, this nigga.
Look, I didn't even know it was that viral too.
This nigga like a shark. He just keep moving and keep breathing. I gotta keep moving. I forgot
about worried
about
that last kill.
I forgot.
Just keep going on. Keep going.
You gotta be like
that's
that.
How you gotta be, man.
You got to.
Sometimes if you look back, you start to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think you didn't, you know,
up.
You didn't overcame. Yeah. You know, I mean, what you have
it might get relaxed.
Yeah, but
might
you don't want to get
foot
relaxed.
Off the pedal.
Exactly.
Never take your foot off
young,
the pedal.
Young Ruger, how are you doing, nigga?
Man, I'm blessed.
How was your day today?
Blessed. It was smooth.
Smooth day.
Can't complain. It's all kind of shit going on, but you know.
Yeah, for
can't
sure.
Can't complain with that. You for sure. You just got to keep it. Like you just said, keep it going.
Any day above ground and right now, this is a blessing.
Amen. I mean,
leaving the house and making it back to your family is like an understatement.
Sure, you know what I mean? That's,
amen. I would admonish niggas to put up one to the Most High and ask for a little help when they step out there, man. And you know what I mean? Because, you know, you can't see 360 degrees, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and I'm always praying too. And the thing is though, man, everything a nigga pray for and I pray hard enough, it come true.
Yeah.
So sometimes you gotta be careful what you pray for. Yeah. You gotta make sure you ready for that.
Yeah, exactly.
You gotta make sure you ready for that, what that blessing come with, you know? Yeah.
That's why they say don't curse nobody.
It's gonna come with pressure.
Yeah, definitely.
Get out of that pressure. Yeah,
if you ain't ready for everything that'll come with, be careful.
Does it come with a lie?
The tongue is a powerful thing.
Yeah, man.
Speak life and death with this motherfucking homie. Speak life and death with
it. Young Ruger, I'ma keep it a buck, man. I've been wanting to chop it up with you since Diddy baby mama was in the hood doing that video shoot with their son. You remember that shit?
Which one was that? When the Muslims was
remember
over
that
there
shit.
Oh, okay.
That was right before she died and shit.
Yeah.
I should have took a picture. I waved.
I took a picture too.
I ain't even take a picture with the bitch. I waved the shit off like I didn't even want to take a picture with her.
She was out there?
What?
I didn't even see her.
You remember when we was talking up under the tree? We was right there right there.
Yeah, yeah.
She walked by us, bro. She had on the. I said, man, that's Diddy baby mama in the hood right there. She had on the Gucci mink.
I think I remember that.
Mink slides.
Yeah. I think I was play fine with Big Zo. I must have been.
Nigga. You was right there.
I was there.
Bull was over there. Yeah.
I was taking pics with the son.
We took pictures with them niggas.
Yeah.
But that's I wanted to chop it up with you ever since then. That nigga, that's how long that was.
That was a while ago. I almost didn't remember the shit. But yeah,
long ass shit, man.
I remember that shit though, man.
Yeah, man. Alright,
here, man. It's on.
Yeah, man. Like it's a beautiful thing, man. I'm glad, you know, and I got you in the with the good
way better equipment.
Yeah, man.
Around that time, we was making shows and the shit ain't racing.
We was kind of
nigga around that time, nigga, we'll do a whole show and next thing you know that motherfucker erase.
Man,
you know what I mean? We got to stop and start over. It's a blessing to come this far with this shit. Yeah.
That's some devastating shit.
Yeah, when you know you got good content. Footage, good content.
Devastating.
And that shit just disappear. Yeah. Fuck no.
Podcast game is way out like that.
Yeah. I had some music.
Yeah.
I used to record at the studio. My boy, my nigga Chad was on the wall. That was like the first studio that I really started going to.
Oh man, we made some bangers there.
I used to be in there for hours, off a little bit of no money, like 12-hour sessions and shit, like just going, rapping, smoking Black and Miles and shit. It's not smoking Blacks and shit. Just going crazy in that motherfucker, though. And then one day I called him to go in there, and this nigga, the computer crashed, I didn't have
the hard drive, just like
the computer, it was old, like, you feel me? And I ain't have none tonight. Everything that I had was just like that was on my phone, but mostly all that shit was gone.
Damn.
And that nigga dog, he used to be making me mad. I used to be thinking that nigga was too high, man.
Yeah, like he used to be, and
he used to be a little bit too high.
I respect him just because he used to be put like, you know, he looked out for a nigga, but boy, he was a lot to deal with. Like I used to be trying, and then I used to try all different kinds of music. Like I know I'm capable of, so I used to try like the shit with the auto tune to this to that, just so I could work on it. But right there, I used to have to go in the booth. You couldn't hear yourself with the auto-tune.
Right.
So I would have to go in there, imagine what I'm sounding like, and try to catch the voice, and then come out, and then he'll put the auto-tune on there, and then I hear what it sound like, and I'm like, all right, that's bullshit. I had to go in there again, like maybe if I say it like this, when he put the auto-tune on there, it'll be smooth. And it'll be just like that. Like I made voices in my head like that.
Mm.
And that's like one of my hardest songs. You feel me? But I made voices in my head like this, like just having to finally catch the tone, and I finally caught it. Just after even just being so goddamn high off that lean and shit too, I would just help me slow down and just really catch like a feel. And then when I finally caught it, after I don't even know how many times, I did the whole thing all the way through. I ain't do no punching there for real.
Yeah.
So I used to do hook, verse, hook, verse, hook, all in one. And just do it, just shit, do it up.
And
so.
This nigga lost.
Oh, shit. Hey, shout out to that nigga Kells, man.
For real.
You know what? I'm going to shout out Kells because, you know, around that time, niggas was kind of struggling. And Kells was coming through, looking out for him. He was fucking up. You was fucking up, Kells. You was looking out, though.
Philly, yeah. Looking out.
Without you, we wouldn't have been able to get a lot of music, wouldn't be out there right now. A lot of content wouldn't be out there right now, but was for Kells.
For sure. And he got better working with a nigga just because I was there so often.
Yeah,
shit.
Yeah.
And I found myself as far as artists. You know what I'm saying? I was finding myself, so shit. It was.
Shout out Kells.
Yeah, on the real.
Yeah.
I never forget that shit. That shit not even there. That studio not even there no more. You feel me? Shout out Drew, too, of my boy Hardy Drew, because that's what shit it was. Like,
and Drew was holding it down.
And Drew was holding it down, man. Like,
all the bells was just falling on him. You know, it was a studio right here, and around it is just like fucking trucks and shit like that. It was like truck stops, and his people end up going to jail, so he had to keep pitching in on the property all by himself. And you know, sometimes Kells not be charging us and be helping us, and Kells ain't got no money for him to help him. You know what,
you know what I'm saying?
So it wasn't. I feel you.
So he was really like looking out for a nigga.
I feel you. So you couldn't
lie for a nigga.
So you couldn't be super mad when that shit crashed.
No, you had to kind of like,
you
feel me?
Yeah, I get
that music. Yeah, it was just like, you feel me? I feel you. I don't know. Just had to keep it pushing, shit. Like,
damn, I used to view that though, like when that shit happened, like whenever niggas that shit crashed, I used to pride myself on being able to repeat the performance though. Like, you gotta be able to do it again. Like, it ain't no luck type shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's the only motivation I got out of that shit. Like,
right.
But all right, niggas in the news, we're gonna come back and we're gonna chop it up with you.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. But niggas can't stay out the news, Boogaloo.
Hell no, they can't.
You know what I'm talking about? They can't, man. Off the top, man, I wanted to ask y'all about the Memphis shit, the straight drop, and the other nigga getting caught.
You talking about the nigga that did that shit to... Who that allegedly did that
allegedly
shit
did
to,
that to Dolph.
To Dolph?
Yeah, yeah.
I wonder what the situation was like. Cause you know I'm seeing pictures and shit on the ground, and he seemed like he was in the crew, and then like he even got recent pictures where he had the
PRE
little keychain.
Oh, so he was from right? He was fucking with them.
Yeah, he was.
I heard like a little something, like something went bad. Like he signed a nigga, the Key Glock, and that nigga didn't fuck with.
That he beef with.
Yeah, like another young nigga that was hot. I don't know.
They felt that it was gonna shit on them.
They didn't like that sign.
That's not enough to kill a man for that.
But then here's the twist, though. Here's what I really wanted to discuss with you is that Straight Drop was gonna turn himself in that Monday, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then he dropped the video. But when he was going to turn himself in, the lawyer that was representing him was a CMG lawyer. You know that, right?
No. I didn't know that.
No, yes. He was a CMG lawyer because he was the nigga that got
Youngstar off of some shit and some other,
And you got him. I mean, he was taking...
That's who got Black Youngstar off the
shooting?
I think
he got him off of that, and he got some of the other people off of that shit.
It was
the
black dude. They was taking pictures with him. Yeah, I seen that.
Yeah.
So, if you from PRE, but then your lawyer fucks with CMG,
But then, like, after he got caught, look, after he got caught and a bunch of people was pointing that shit out on, you know, niggas online is pointing that out. It's a bunch of motherfuckers on some detective shit, right? Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
It's always like that.
Internet in general.
It's motherfuckers who already had peeped that. So when he turned to, when he got caught, the lawyer took himself off his thing.
He got because off of that case?
Because of the feedback from the internet?
Right, right, right. He was representing him before, and then once he got caught,
he jumped off the case.
He jumped off the case.
Wow.
Once it came out that he was CMG.
Right. So I feel like the FBI is going to be on... Something ain't adding up, something not right. The FBI is going to be on Gotti. Like,
if you from PRE... But your lawyer, like, why? It seems like you was mad about the situation and you went to the CMG niggas. I can get them for y'all. Shoot me this X amount of money. Then when the shit happens, CMG, we got a lawyer for you too. Facts. That's exactly what it looked like.
He had bread too.
He had bread.
Damn, you know he dropped a video right after they did that, Dolph got popped. They dropped the song called Stepped On.
Yeah. I seen that. How do you feel he was looking in that video?
What you mean?
As far as like, did he look like he was on the run to you?
Bro, like I said, man, them niggas like was at a gas station. But they was at a gas station though.
Yeah, little video.
It kind of seemed like he probably already had it in the.
Man, they could have had it, but look, if let's look at it like
had
this.
Had that in the vault and just dropped some.
At the gas station though?
Right. If you on the run, you're not going to be. Well, I would hope you wouldn't be in public.
That's your alternative. The gas station is
shit. Right, and you're on camera.
That's why I think they was, dude, I think that was his cameraman. I think they was planning on shooting videos, like running and just shooting videos and just displaying
putting shit out there.
I don't give a fuck. Yeah. I'm not worried type shit. And they probably
nigga moving like that, man. That's dumb.
You don't think that's bro?
That's some dumb shit. Yeah, that's some way out shit.
That's some dumb shit if he's moving like that, though.
But what if he? Okay, now let's think about it.
Alright.
What if he feel like he gonna beat the case?
Because
look, okay, let's look at it. Okay, now we gotta go back to.
You ain't did nothing. You fuck around, and just continue to drop. Like you know, just like how you just.
He probably playing it like that. That's what you're saying. Like, you know what I'm saying?
I ain't did nothing.
Trying to take that route.
I was already finna drop this shit and drop the video. I mean, or the nigga could have shot the. I don't know.
Hey man, like.
But I feel like then. I mean, if that's on your name in the streets. I feel like you might not, even if you is, like, you know, you didn't do nothing. If that's just on your name in the street, you're not finna be shooting no videos out there like that.
Facts.
Even a nigga like, nigga ain't did nothing, but.
That's coming from your thinking. You raised a certain type of way with certain type of niggas, so your mind state is different.
Right.
Clearly, the Memphis niggas is on some other shit. We already see.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Niggas is on some other shit with this, bro. Like, I don't think niggas is really.
So look, you think.
See, because you got to look at how much clout Straight Drop got. His clout started going up dramatically.
Now that's why
the last couple of days. Yeah. And so when I seen the nigga at the gas station.
Yeah, that was.
I was like, this nigga is really don't give a fuck. Niggas is on the run. The reason why I say gas station is because it's some bullshit. If you shooting a video, where you shooting your video at, bro? You trying to be around something nice? You trying to do something? To me, the gas station is just a place where we at, where ain't nobody noticing us, and it's some good lighting.
Where the number one question comes from?
Shooting videos everywhere now.
Well, number one question comes.
Okay, I feel you.
Anywhere, you know what I'm saying?
Where was that gas station located at? That's the question. Was that gas station in Memphis?
I don't know. They had a little aerial footage of Memphis. That little, they had a little
it
drone.
Was downtown Memphis.
They had a little drone footage. And then I'm saying, like, why was the nigga with him? Why are you gonna even have somebody with you if he not like somebody important, like a fucking cameraman? You know what I'm saying?
It's that
I know
money.
That sounds stupid as fuck though.
It's that bag.
If they could have kept, if they could have kept running and he had like maybe 10 songs, he could have kept releasing videos. All he needed was new gear.
Right.
And because, the money.
I mean, a lot of people were tuning in to him.
I know that sounds dumb as fuck. It's like, don't stop.
A lot of people tuning in to him. That's why when he dropped the video, in my mind, I'm like, okay, he trying to... He's trying to finesse off this situation and make some M's before they catch his ass. 100,000 M's, whatever he's trying to do. He's trying to make some money off the situation about everybody saying a nigga killed Dolph or whatever. He's trying to cash the fuck out.
How could he cash out before this? To me, it's like setting the stage for when he go in and actually begin to fight the case.
Well, when you independent artist.
Yeah, that money.
You get all that money.
You get it right now?
No, you ain't gonna get it right now, but it'll be there.
But you get it off the YouTube, you get it off the Spotify.
It start going up.
Right.
I mean, him having that like that attached to his name, of course people gonna
watch
that video.
Yeah. Right.
The always wanna see who somebody beefing with.
It's almost a million, you know. What you make off a million, like 2 racks or something like that?
I don't know, but I know YouTube don't really ain't chipping off too much.
It's that Apple Music,
Spotify, and shit like that.
What's that shit that Jay-Z got?
Tidal,
they pay good.
Get some streams.
Let me grab a bud out of that, man. Yeah.
I just rolled that shit up.
It's gone.
Hit that shit.
It's all gone.
You want to hit this, man?
It's all good. I'm working over here.
So what do you feel about the situation? What are you saying?
What you mean?
What do you feel about the whole situation about him being on the run and all that? Do you think that he had these videos in the vault, or are he making videos on the run?
Well,
honest opinion.
He caught now. I felt like I said, man. I was like, niggas is on the run.
Yeah.
And they don't give a fuck.
Yeah,
they don't
get,
he don't give a fuck.
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking, as soon as I saw it, I was like, damn, he got a nigga that was actually down to do this with him. Like, it's a nigga, it's a cameraman. You feel me?
A lot of cameramans' pockets, let's keep it 100, a lot of cameramans ain't on like that. Them niggas' pockets is hurting. They'll do whatever for a dollar.
Going on a run with a nigga, even if it's going on a run with a killer, we don't know if he went on a run with him.
But
he got charged with that. That's it. Okay, it's not like okay.
So the cameraman,
cameraman got charged for accessory to the accessory people. After the fact. So that's like
he can beat that though.
What does that mean?
That means he's around a nigga that's on the run
and ain't turning him in, basically.
Right.
So you get accessory.
You didn't turn him in. You helped him.
But all he got to do is say
that
this video was filmed prior to, and I just hope he have proof of that. Now, if he ain't got proof of that,
I think the case is irrelevant. He was in the car with him. I think he was driving. So
they only know when they uploaded it.
Hold on. The cameraman was in the car with him while he got caught out of state.
You didn't hear what I was saying.
They
was on the run together.
I'm wondering why you keep saying he was on the run together.
Listen, okay. My point is like, why was this nigga in the car with him? If you're on that much, if you're on the run that like that, if you on fire like that, the only logic I can see is if you're filming.
Right.
Which is important for this right now.
Right.
The cameraman is important. I'm just saying.
Right. But everything changes now that
he was driving.
Was driving. Yeah. And got caught with the nigga.
With them. They was together. That's what I'm trying to say, bro. So now, it wasn't like they caught him by himself and let's go find the cameraman. No, they together.
And caught these motherfuckers. Cameraman was driving. So that means what you were saying. These motherfuckers want to go all over.
They was just going to keep.
And film these videos.
Edit on the run.
And trying to go viral off the situation. And okay, I get you then. I get you. Yeah. Stupid ass cameraman.
I get that.
Damn.
And that might stick, though, because, I mean, like I said, he's... That's wanted close, and you're filming.
Yeah, now
or you're in a car with him. Why are you?
You put it like that. That's gonna stick because he got caught with the nigga. If he filmed the video and went home,
and then and we the don't know what continue, they found in the car too. Right. Then the equipment, if they had all that, exactly. They didn't even say nothing about that. They just said he was helping him. We got him.
That changes everything. If he wouldn't have got caught with the nigga who filmed it, okay, I went home and I uploaded. No, you filming it, then going to another city with this nigga, probably even filmed most shit, and then got gaffled with this nigga.
Ain't got the editor yet. Got finished, they ain't got the edit.
Right.
And I was just like, I was amazed off of the nigga countenance. Like, the nigga, you know, the way the nigga was.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that wasn't too smart, champ.
But nigga, I mean, you know,
that wasn't too smart, champ.
I don't know, man. We gonna see.
Yeah, he gonna be. It's gonna be.
Oh, but this. And then another thing too, though. Like, we just at the bottom level of this. Like I said,
we ain't even.
Yeah. Yeah. Thought about what if niggas tell, what if niggas, you know.
Oh, that cameraman tell him.
What if, you know what I'm saying, what if, but he might not know the depth of.
That nigga
let's say if that was some CMG type shit, okay. He might not know all the details of that. Might think, oh boy, just did it and just was.
Well, he definitely know that the nigga was on the run for killing Dolph. He for sure know that. Ain't no way around it. He know that.
It's probably a cameraman. Probably his father, man. He probably.
He a nigga from Memphis, too, that had moved to Dallas. So it was his partner.
Probably his cousin or something.
And you know, they was hitting every spot that they had been at. You know what I'm saying?
That's why they had gas stations and shit.
Hey, man.
The niggas are filling up and taking shots.
I didn't know a gang of people in the shop videos at gas station.
I'm knowing, and you right about that. You know what I'm saying? But I was just, you know, theorizing, just like, cause I was like, man, niggas is releasing videos while they is super lava, super. Yeah, they super super hot. Saying the feds watching me. Matter of fact, nigga might have recorded. It might have been a new song. Nigga saying the feds watching me from fake accounts and shit. That was some of the lyrics in
there. That's a lyric? Yeah, nigga. Then that for sure. He made that shit after that shit with Dolph. Them niggas probably made that shit downtown.
In Memphis.
Memphis.
Yeah.
On their way out of Memphis. Nigga made that shit on his way out of Memphis and posted that shit up. And if they got any more videos, nigga ain't even get a chance to edit that motherfucker. We might never see them motherfuckers. We might not never, but guess what? It's gonna pop up in court, though.
Now
it's gonna pop up in court.
They always playing somebody music.
Now what if this go back to Gotti, though? Like, what if the feds get involved? Let's go back to Gotti.
It's gonna be all bad, man. I don't know, man. I don't wish nothing on a nigga.
It ain't wish.
It's like a sooner.
It ain't even wish. I'm just saying, like,
Gotti got too much ties and certain shit. You know what I mean?
I don't think so, though.
You don't think so?
The lawyer can work with whoever. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can't tie me to that because this lawyer.
Only if the nigga don't tell him.
The lawyer did that.
Now, the only way that I feel that. Let
somebody
that,
say, yeah, they got this lawyer for me.
The only way I feel like that Gotti is out of that situation, if don't nobody that's so, in the case mention him. Yeah. Like, if that cameraman mentioned him, or the nigga who allegedly killed him said, Gotti told me and paid me.
Okay, they putting full hot fire on the cameraman.
You damn right.
They charging him with first degree murder. They charging right. him with the full whatever.
They trying to scare him.
Everything that happened to Dolph is on the cameraman, too.
They trying to scare the fuck out of him to get the nigga.
And they separated niggas off the. From the gate, they sent old boy back to Memphis, and they sent the cameraman back to Texas or wherever, to Dallas or wherever, you know. So they hitting him with that in Dallas.
I mean, I pray Gotti beat that. I pray Gotti.
Well, no, he ain't got no charge.
Just don't mention him.
They can't mention him.
As long as niggas just don't mention him. It's just a speculation.
I feel like these niggas is I feel like these niggas is horrible niggas. So I feel like what'll keep him from telling is his family.
Yeah.
Stuff happening to his family.
Yeah.
That'd probably be the only thing that
nigga
keep him from
that
telling.
Threat to you, nigga.
You gotta go closed. Through the hole. You gotta go through all of this. You can't.
Yeah, nigga, you want your baby mama alive?
Mama, grandmama. Yeah. See, that you know, it's everybody is out there in the open. Like,
I'm out of time. Niggas play different, man. I seen a situation where a nigga did something. They couldn't find him, so they smoked the nigga baby mama. You know what I mean? So they play a little different. You know what I mean? It's a little different.
I
already heard them doing stuff to like niggas did stuff to black youngster grandmama houses.
That was false though.
Oh, okay.
They said they shot up black youngster mama house and Yo Gotti, they shot up his mama restaurant. But that was false.
What about the one rapper they say he shot up his grandmama house?
Nigga with the red hair, yeah, they really shot up his people. That was true.
You know what I'm talking about?
I think he got
his name, Honeycomb.
Honeycomb.
Oh, yeah.
They did. That's so true.
Yeah.
And then when the Instagram kept saying that, throwing that out there about Gotti Mama restaurant and shit, the police, I guess wherever the restaurant is, an important place. So the police went there and had, like, you know, heavy security in that area.
Because I think probably
the white folks, you know, shopping that area or something like
that.
Oh,
it's because it's white people over there.
White people over there. Where the status is in a good area. So
that was smart how he did that.
Yeah.
Because if he'd have put it where the niggas was at, it would be some drama for sure.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's always a good best. Put your business in a...
By the white people.
Those areas.
Hell yeah, you know what I'm saying.
It's nothing wrong with putting it in your hood too though. That's always, I ain't gonna say it like that though, but that would always be your best bet though, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You get better customers. You know what I'm saying? Just all the shit like that.
They say black youngster grandma was in the hospital. So, you know what I mean? Around that time she wasn't even at her house. She was in the hospital dealing with some little shit. You know how the internet, man.
Right.
Throwing shit out there that was not true.
Instagram want to see the words.
Yeah.
Man, Ruger, when the last time you had a show? Have you done any shows?
Yeah, I just had just did a show not too long ago. What was that?
New Year's.
Okay. I thought I'd seen something. How was that turn out for
it was
that?
Smooth, man. So, Wally brought us out. Wally had a show. Wally brought us out. Me, my boy Fofo, my boy Buddha Swavey, Earl Swavey.
Rest in peace, Earl.
Yeah, rest in peace, my dog, man. Rest in peace, Earl, dog.
Let's go ahead and address that. Yeah, the Earl Swavey, rest in peace. I was in the gym, I didn't get a hand from now, bitch. Bitches fucking homies with the hopeless nigga around shit. Send and cut the birdie from my miller out the pound quick. Bust it down the pound, nigga, smoke about it.
But you go retarded like a nigga need counsel. Sipping the pink, I'm a wear breast cancer. 40 in a phantom and these girls got me frantic. I've been betrayed by the hoes and the homies. Stack bread on my lonely. You niggas don't know me. I fled out the road. Like 23 years on me. Changing my hood, it's not homies. Niggas too fast. So I ride with the thug. Couple niggas betrayed. Got here with the case. Was never the same. But two in his brain. Cause I've been betrayed. Stuck a knife in my back. How could you lie to my face? I've been betrayed.
Yeah, man, it's like every other day is some bullshit, man.
Well,
yes.
I seen somebody made a statement like, man, they didn't took, they literally just took all my favorite rappers away. And the nigga that made the statement fucked with Slim, like with his music.
Uh-huh.
Tiny West and Earl Swavey shit.
Wow.
So that's his statement. Oh, yeah. Facts, dog. Every other day, man. Like leaving your house and coming home, like cut in half. Like leaving your house and come home is like an understatement. Like, nigga, so much bullshit going on. You know what I mean? From ducking the police. You know what I mean? Ducking your enemies. You know what I mean? The shit that life throw at you. Like, it's so much shit going make on, it, man. Real. Motherfucker really gotta really just show who he is right now at the situation. You know what I mean? Nigga really gotta hop over these motherfucking obstacles because they keep getting old at you, you know. Earl Swavey was a good dude, man. I was a good nigga right there, man. Oh, he was a real rapper. He just got off tour, mm-hmm, doing some shit. You
all
feel
the different states and all that. I met up with him when I flew to Detroit and went out there and fucked with them, man. Wally and Earl, they let me perform and shit. I got to perform out there in Detroit.
I saw that.
Went crazy.
I saw that. Yeah.
That shit was like a real experience and shit, seeing how niggas rock the crowd and shit. I don't really, you know, I done had some shows, but I ain't really had, you know, Earl Swavey been doing this shit. He was one of the first ones really putting on for this shit for real. As far as like, you know, like young niggas and shit, like Earl been rapping, like
been rapping.
Yeah.
15, 14, been nigga rapping. Been rapping, like take like to sand it out, like that song was like 100,000 YouTube back then. Mm. You know what I'm saying? That shit was going crazy, so. Yeah, Earl was just in the studio shit the day before shit. 8 at night, about 4 or 5 in the morning.
Y'all made a couple songs.
Hell yeah.
Okay, so we got unreleased Earl Swavey and Ruger music.
Yeah, some
on the
songs
way
and shit, man. Shit.
Damn, you remember your last words with him?
Yeah, hell yeah. I told that nigga be beautiful. Shit, I love you, nigga. I don't buy that.
Man.
Shit, since everything been going on, shit, nigga, just make it a habit of really telling niggas that nigga love. Just
always.
That like, nigga love you, nigga. Shit, nigga shook his hand, told him be barefoot, nigga love you, fool. Shit, nigga love you too, nigga. Told him, shit, my baby mama tripping, I'm out of here. We was finishing up the song, she was steady tripping on the nigga, and shit called and shit. He ain't sweating on the phone because the nigga freestyle everything, you feel me? Lately, I've been freestyling everything, shit, since the last few months.
Yeah.
But shit, when I got in there with him, it was like more of a, he going in there, boom, he coming up with it fast, 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 and he just take off the headphones and pass them to a nigga, like, I'm like, damn, okay.
That nigga been doing himself for some years, man.
Yeah, all right.
You can see that by being in the room with him, like in the studio, and the nigga ain't been home from jail that long, neither. He just seemed like, I think, his first week or so when he was out, the homie had passed away, somebody that was real close to him.
Mm-hmm. Then there got out right around that time.
Like right around
day
that
of
time,
his funeral dinner, the day before.
Yeah, yeah, he was fucked off behind that shit.
Mm-hmm. I was best friends. Mm-hmm. Homie Nez, rest in peace, man.
This shit happened to him. Damn, dog.
Did a lot of people get shot in that incident or just him, or was it?
That shit just a whole other type of incident, but. Yeah.
I think did they say it was a leg wound that hit a main artery, I think.
I'm not sure.
Damn, nigga died from something like that?
Yeah, it was something that hit a main artery. The details ain't really clear right now.
Right.
Of what exactly happened, but that's one thing that a couple people have said, that it was a leg hit that hit a main artery. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. I had heard about it on No Jumper and shit. Adam 22 and them were talking about that.
Yeah, yeah. I seen a couple of blogs posted it too.
Yeah. His hit, what was his hit record? His number, his
Jigga
most.
Man.
What's the name of it?
Jigga Man.
Jigga Man, okay. Right.
Damn.
That was something we was doing that night. I did the remix on that shit.
Damn.
Yeah, that shit in Detroit. When I went out there, I got on the remix and shit. Then they had lost the stems and shit, so I had to redo it. That's how we ended up getting there that night and just fucking around and shit with that shit. I got on there and shit. We actually performed since we already had the song from Detroit. So on New Year's, that's where we performed and shit. When I got up there, me and him did that shit just to like just fuck it, show it off real quick. Shit wasn't even done. He had other people on there. Man Gang, Lonnie, P4 from the Baby Stone Gorillas. Mm-hmm. Got a YS. Got YS 30 shot on there. Who else on there?
I like them Baby Stone Gorilla niggas.
Yeah, I fuck with them. They are.
Yeah, we talking braids. Yeah.
Man, Earl, man, he just changed his Instagram name too that I recently seen. Dirty. It was called Old Dirty Earl. But on I think it was Hulu, they had the Wu-Tang special out.
Oh,
so
yeah.
A lot of motherfuckers like really like got introduced to Wu-Tang story and what they went through and shit like that. That you know, you got Old Dirty Bastard from there, and he was always outspoken and wild and all that shit. So of course Earl, you know, changed just to Old Dirty Earl.
Right.
That's for Old Dirty Bastard,
yeah,
you know.
Little dreads, yeah. Wow, that little dreads,
yeah,
up top.
Yeah, he
and
got
shit.
That kind of like little style, kind of like wild.
Damn.
Like that.
The dirtiest.
Yeah. Man. Good homie, dog.
Rest in peace, man. It's a lot of niggas dying right now, man. It's just so many motherfuckers dying and old motherfuckers too, man. Like everything, everybody.
Yeah,
like,
everybody dying. Old people dying off coronavirus. Young people dying off gunshots. It seems like fucked up right now, man. It's like, like bad. It's like all the motherfuckers that you know they had EDD money, man. They kind of like fumbled their bag.
Yeah.
But before they did, they bought guns.
And they just.
So everybody got guns. Everybody got hand pistols. Everybody got sticks. Everybody got fullies. You know what I mean? Everybody may not have money, but they got guns.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? And they hitting streets with them. And niggas is really able to war with each other. It ain't no off even war right now because this hood got more guns than this hood. It's like kind of like everybody got guns now, so it's like motherfuckers just dying left and right, dog.
Dying. I wonder if the government wanted it to be like that.
Man, I seen a post before.
Wanted niggas to just be fully armed and y'all niggas just go at it. We give y'all a burst of money. And then we just take all the money away and then it's just hunger. Yeah. Not it was Squid Games, Hunger Games type shit.
I definitely wasn't no coincidence. I think all that shit was planned. Cause you know all that pandemic shit, them putting that shit in the air or whatever the fuck they did. I seen the interview when somebody was talking about that shit that was about to happen, like in 2005 or some shit. 2005 or 2015, where a lady was talking about what they were gonna be doing, and it actually happened.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I ain't no
Simpsons probably know the story.
Right, you know what I mean? I ain't no theory.
Simpsons know everything.
Right, I ain't no motherfucker that's be, you know, just speaking about theories and all. Like I said, I always look up the facts. Those are facts. That lady knew about that shit.
Hey man, well, we in the twist now for sure.
Hell yeah.
I know it's up out there, man. Niggas is, you know. Man. Well, rest in peace to your man, bro, Earl Swavey, bro. All right, let's keep it going and hopefully lighten up the mood a little bit. Your boy Kanye took off on a motherfucker on a fan.
Now, the incident happened around 3 o'clock this morning, according to our sources. Kanye West was leaving. A fan says he saw Kanye sitting in his car and walked up to the window to ask him for an autograph. Words were exchanged. What those words are, well, that's all part of the police investigation. But the fan told officers that Kanye jumped out of his car, called him some, let's say, words not suitable for television, and then punched him, knocking him to the ground. The artist then left. Police were called. A police report has been filed, and the incident is being investigated. By the time officers got here, Kanye West was not here. They have not spoken to him yet. Obviously, he'll have his side of the story to tell, but he is being investigated for this battery charge. It is considered a misdemeanor, so most likely he wouldn't have even been arrested, even if he were.
That nigga's so angry, man. That nigga be angry.
What's going on with Kanye, man, right now, man?
Nigga can smile.
Fan might have walked up on some bullshit.
He just turned even quick. No,
they said it was early in the morning or something.
Would you let Kanye take off on you?
Nah, hell no.
You go ahead and beat his ass thoroughly.
Kanye, I wouldn't give a fuck.
And then a little suit a nigga too.
Yeah, you put your hands on.
What's that? That's at least 100. That's at least 100.
Nigga, hope somebody filmed that shit, man.
Fucking with Kanye, man. He put his hands on the nigga.
I don't know what's up with that nigga though, man.
Kanye be tripping though, man. He not even the type of nigga you might want even want to walk up to when I ask for an autograph just because the type of shit he be on.
But you know them white people be loving him like that. They be like,
yeah, Ellen. Ellen love that nigga. What's the name? Ellen the gay white girl Ellen on TV. Jenner. Ellen Jenner, man, she love that nigga.
Ass ain't on TV no more.
Yeah, she ain't. I think she got Tiffany Haddison probably took her place.
They all, I think.
What?
I'm not saying they took her play, but they got her own now. Tiffany Haddison got her own TV show coming out, and that's supposed to like.
Remember they took Ellen off TV?
No, you fuck with Tiffany Haddison? You fuck with her?
Shit. So I fuck with Tiffany. Yeah, she funny sometimes. You know, she cool. I fuck with her. It ain't like no big ass fan, but like I respect what she doing. She a black woman trying to make it.
Yeah.
So I fuck with her just on that. You know what I mean? So
yeah, my support. Yeah, yeah. Just because she black. Yeah, I feel you.
I'm going to show my support.
I feel you.
But yeah, Kanye, man. You know, that nigga Kanye just popping it. You know what I mean? I was watching that that interview with the Drink Champs.
Yeah.
And that nigga said he texted Jay-Z.
Told him I got more
money than all y'all put together. How you gonna talk to a nigga like that that didn't put you on and put you in a position, nigga? Like, nigga be just, he be having like a little spaz out episodes.
Who you say worst garbage? Big Sean?
Yeah, he talking bad about Big Sean. He said that's the worst thing I could have did was sign Big Sean. Big Sean wasn't feeling that shit neither.
He did the interview with Drink Champs right after.
And Big Sean kept trying to change the subject. Like, that was some bullshit. And man, like, hold on, we're going to get to that. Like, they get to talking about some other shit. Then he'll go back to man, that was some bullshit. Like, and they're like, hold on. We're not on that yet. Like, just chill.
He's trying to get to that shit.
Right. He kept trying to get to it. And then, you know, towards the end, they got to it. Then he said a couple of words, said a little word about it. Then he was like, oh, then I don't want to talk about it no more. It's over there. Like, damn, you wanted to talk about this shit the whole interview. Now when it came up, you said what you said. Now you ready to
say. Hey, man, I after that Drink Champs interview, I thought Big Sean was weird, kind of like a little bit. I thought
a little weird. What you peep up?
Like, I mean, I see his side of it, you know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. But I still thought he was a little, like, whatever Kanye had to say, he kind of probably, like, deserved a little bit of it.
Deserved a little bit of that shit.
You know what I mean? Like, it was both sides. It wasn't like...
Yeah, I felt...
You know, Kanye was wrong 100% or Big Sean was right. It was kind of like...
What about Big Sean as an artist?
I like him.
He real but then, lyrical.
But
I don't fuck around.
But look,
he real like lyrical.
I like him.
I don't think he's too lyrical like that.
You didn't let me finish what I was gonna say.
Okay, go ahead.
I like him. But I feel like whatever creative peak he had, he experienced it a long time ago, and he went through that shit, and now it's like his music don't hit this. It don't have this. It don't ring off the same as when he first came in the game. If that make any type of sense. And it wasn't like I was thought he was that dope when he came in.
But it was cool.
He had like little catchy shit he was saying that would kind of catch your attention and shit. But now I feel like he done burnt out that whatever that formula is, and now he don't really, you know.
Then
here's another thing that I think happened to him too. Here's the twist too. Is he a Detroit nigga, right? So he in a certain lane, and then all that other Detroit shit come out, and he don't have nothing to do with it really.
He could try to do songs with them, but it sounds forced. Yeah, it don't sound.
He ain't part of that.
Yeah.
So to me, when something like that happens, that could wipe your career out.
Yeah.
Because of the authenticity of them niggas coming through. They know that's the real Detroit sound. So what are you really? You like some kind of commercial fantasy,
out of touch
type
bigger.
Of motherfucker.
I be wondering why he's not bigger than what he is. Like,
And then being over there with Jhené Aiko as your bitch.
He had his run.
I like the nigga.
He had his run.
Because the nigga, I can say whatever, but I be seeing the nigga lyrical shit up there with the J. Cole's and the Kendricks and all that shit. I really listened to the nigga.
He was up there, but I think that bitch threw him off, because you got to pay attention to that bitch.
Wait a minute, though.
You got to pay attention to that bitch.
Let me say something now, real fast. I love Jhené Aiko, and I think she, you crazy as a motherfucker. She ain't never going to throw a nigga off. Man, don't do it.
Okay.
Like that.
You think? Hey, but look, okay, let me tell you how a nigga get thrown off.
He might have got too involved. Yeah, by like getting too involved and got just head over heels.
If you fuck with her, you throw it off.
I think you're he got head over heels.
You gotta percentage of your attention has to go to this bitch.
Definitely.
And right now you gotta fight. Yeah. You fighting for your life as a rapper. How you gonna do that?
Yeah, he might have got head over heels and got too involved.
I think sometimes when you got a big bitch like that, you trying to maintain a big bitch like that in your career.
Yeah. But y'all didn't talk about, he didn't been, y'all talking about J. Cole and Kendrick. Come on,
but
man.
That's him.
Yeah, that's me. Yeah. I'm going to stand by it.
I ain't going to say he's on that level. I don't think so. He was right there with Drake.
But I mean, he was right there with Drake at one point. You know, he had the way up, I Feel Blessed.
And Drake
he
is
was
at
doing
the top.
His thing.
And Drake is at the top.
Right now, he's at his top. But I'm saying right then, they was like at the same.
What I'm saying is, once upon a time, and I stand on this, Big Sean was mentioned. Not saying he's better, was mentioned. Up there, and we all know this. He was mentioned up there.
I remember he was mentioned up there when they had that song out with all them niggas on it, ASAP Rocky and all that.
Yes. He was mentioned up there with the Kendrick, the J. Cole. He was mentioned up there. Y'all can't sit up here and say, y'all didn't see that. Y'all
corny
can't sit up here.
Man,
he
Big Sean, corny as a motherfucker.
Man, he may be corny now.
He used to be hard.
But he was
in the beginning. When he first came out, he was hard. When he had maybe like the first sums, like the mixtapes, I can't really think of the name and shit like that.
Have you listened to any of his albums?
Hey, man.
Yeah, a long time ago.
I don't think y'all tuned in.
Hey, man, trying to keep up with that bitch.
He had ass with Nicki Minaj.
He got some good lyrics.
Yeah.
You know what
I'm saying? He had some bull little songs.
The way he ride the beat, all that shit.
His lyrics is introspective and thoughtful. Some of his new shit caught my ear. He not whack. He got a song with Bryson Tiller or some shit.
He ain't garbage.
But you just putting him up there with a high place.
Yeah, come on,
I'm telling y'all, bro. I'm telling y'all, bro.
Them niggas, blood. He cannot go platinum or do none of that shit by himself without a feature. He can't do that. Like J. Cole and Kendrick, he can't.
Have
he? I don't think now, man. I don't think he can do that.
I don't know if he have. I don't know. I don't know the specifics.
What's the man?
But he, I don't think he can do that. They can
he
do
probably
that.
Can't.
They been capable.
Hey, man, listen. I'm going to keep it a buck. Listen, let me break
I'm
down my
about his lyrics.
Right.
If his lyrics is hard enough,
I'm trying to tell you, man. How long you been fucking with Janae? About 5 years or some shit? Or 4 years or some shit?
If I was fucking with Janae right now, which I'm going after her anyways. If I'd be at my motherfucking peak.
Okay, let me point some shit out. How you know? Let me point some shit out. See,
love Janae.
He got a house out here because of that bitch in Beverly Hills and shit.
As he should.
Cause she stay out here.
Right. Now you know, to me, man, like when you know, I don't know. This may sound different to y'all. But when you trying to be like, to me, like when you like a good, when you like a good rapper, you gotta, to me, you gotta be in your soil a lot to maintain like a.
That's 100% true.
You gotta to
maintain. I say how I feel at the finish talking.
You gotta maintain a connection. You gotta be around. You can't live in another state. Like if you from, you know what I'm saying. I don't think you can maintain your connection to the ground thoroughly if you live in a whole nother state.
You're gonna start doing something different.
And then you look at, like I say, Big Sean, you got this whole movement that just come up, you feel me? And you over here with Janae Aiko, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I love her. She's a beautiful bitch. You know, we want to have her on the team. You know what I'm saying? I ain't blaming shit on her, but a bad bitch will distract a motherfucker and have you doing some other shit that you don't need to be doing.
No, you right.
Instead of focusing on, you know, what made you great in the first place.
We've seen it. We've seen it time and time again. We've seen it with Offset. We've seen it with what's the main Migo with the dreads that was fucking with the
bad Quavo.
Bitch, Quavo.
Yeah.
We've seen it with Wiz. We've seen it with Kanye. We've seen all these motherfuckers get into relationships with these bad bitches and their music starts to fall down. Right?
Right.
Now, let's talk about Drake, right? You didn't really hear Drake too many times. You ain't really hear Drake in these big...
Drake is a motherfucking player.
You ain't hearing him in these big relationships and all that shit. And he got more hits than all them niggas because he was always able to stay fucking focused. That nigga just fucking bitches. You know what I mean?
And
fucking
booting
bitches.
Them.
And booting
and cutting them loose.
He wasn't having no girlfriend.
And separation.
And no public relationship. He wasn't doing that.
Separation.
And the nigga was coming with hit after hit after hit. Future was even coming for a minute. Hit after hit after hit. Shit kind of slowed down when he started fucking with Sierra.
Too many.
And then once he fell out of love with Sierra, nigga, boom.
Started going crazy.
When he fell out of love.
Monster.
And he said it in his Drop lyrics.
The tape. Monster.
He said, yes, he said about the best thing he could have ever did was fall out of love. And that nigga hit us with mixtape, hit.
Brazy.
Going brazy to the point they was trying to sign that nigga. They was trying to get that nigga $50 million on a motherfucking signing deal. And falling out of love is what got him there.
Hey, man. I would pursue niggas. Niggas ain't gonna want to accept this, but man, I believe there's a direct relation to the number of nuts you bussing to your creativity. Now I know niggas is like, don't want to hear no shit like that. I know niggas don't want to hear no shit like that, but look, let me point out some shit.
This nigga boss back up.
Ooh,
look.
This amount of busting next to your creativity. Look,
listen.
Oh, shit. Talk to me. Talk to me.
Okay, now let's say a nigga become great. A nigga escalate in his, whatever his field of crap area is. Mm-hmm. Let's say it's music. He escalate up.
Mm-hmm.
What's the first thing he do? Bad bitch. The baddest, the my dream bitch.
Yeah. And then that's what.
And all his energy into that.
Right. Right. And everybody and that nigga, helped him on the way nigga, just get
then,
together.
Then nigga creativity just do this.
Right.
And nigga creativity just do this.
Everybody helped him on the way. Look, everybody that helped him on the way
pussy
to get
Trump
there.
Pussy Trump all that.
Is forgot
pussy,
about.
Pussy Trump all that.
He forgot about all
pussy
of
Pussy Trump
them.
All that.
He's buying her the Birkins.
Pussy Trump all that.
Her the cars and all that shit.
One of the classic ones was, man, when I was watching Wiz blow up with the Taylor Gang. I was just watching the Taylor Gang video. I was like, this little nigga doing it. I'm God like
that. Slow down till you got
then,
to that ball head,
Amber
bitch.
Rose. Then it just stopped. I'm like,
slow
man.
The fuck down, dog. Slow the fuck down. You out living life with your bad bitch.
I don't even want to watch that shit no more. It just look like
focus.
The homies can't come around no right. more like that.
Forgot it's about your whole team.
Creativity man. Start.
Yeah.
It ain't the same tightness.
Yeah.
Niggas start doing this shit when they get that accept. Now, I'm not saying banish bitches. I'm talking about when a nigga jump up to grab that accept. Oh, shit. This bad bitch.
And he loses focus.
I got her. Right. And he just... You feel me?
He lose focus.
Leave his shit over here.
Yeah.
Just that. That's.
Womp, womp, womp. Time after time.
How do we get to that? What got us to there?
Kanye.
Kanye.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. The Rowdy Rich thing before we get into Ruger.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Let me address that right quick now.
Talk to us.
How you feel about that, Rowdy Rich being pressed by this man from his, now? I know you. We know more dynamics than what the normal people know.
Definitely.
So, you know,
I fuck with L Dog too, though, man. Cool nigga, but
yeah,
he should have been a little bit more prepared.
Yeah,
on.
No, L Dog.
He wasn't prepared.
Gotta be a little bit more prepared
yeah.
of what you was gonna say to this nigga and how you felt about it.
Right.
You know what I mean? When you got on the when you got on, damn shit, fucking up. But when he got, you know,
I can hear you. I can hear you though. Don't trip though.
Yeah.
So push the thing down. The foam on the mic. Just, yeah, there you go. Right.
So when he got on the phone call, Roddy kind of had control of the whole situation.
He lost the verbal sparring.
Yeah, I just wish. He probably right about what he's saying. We don't know.
Let me.
He couldn't back it enough.
I want to make a point about that. A point about that. So that's. That's two separate different kind of conversations
yeah.
or arguments. It's one that could be had in front of people, and then it's the one that could really be had in the hood in front of the homies only.
Right.
You feel me?
Right.
And your boy tried to bring that conversation that you can only have with the homies. He tried to bring that in front of regular people.
To the public.
And his argument fell apart. And it made him seem crazy.
Yeah.
So niggas got to be careful with how they approach the clubhouse shit. Whack kind of put him in a fucked up position, I think.
He probably agreed to talk.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's what Whack played in that. Whack was
he just set him up to talk.
He was
to
the
each
yeah.
other.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get him on here. I'm gonna get you on here.
We gonna talk about it in front of the world.
Right. But see. Wack know that the other nigga don't have the communication skills to win in this arena right here. Mm. And it's going to automatically make him look stupid. Which might make the situation worse.
Yeah, definitely. Because I'm pretty sure it's niggas from Park Village that hear that probably wasn't feeling that. Probably wasn't feeling that. Yeah. But you got to understand, man, that nigga Roddy is a is a rapper. He's a rap star. He's
right.
He's not gonna get on the internet and let somebody punk him or make him, you know, seem all like he ain't gonna do
try
that.
To put that on his name.
He ain't gonna do that name. Because he got a lot to stand for. He got a lot riding on this. You know what I mean?
Right.
So he not. It could have been. It could have been somebody, even his own brother, somebody close to him. He's not about to get on the internet and let a nigga punk him.
Right.
Man, the rapper. Your sales will go down. Your motherfucker, when you come to your motherfucking shows, it was a lot riding on that conversation. And you always hear about these clubhouse conversations. Somebody and somebody that got into it. Somebody and somebody that got into it. And it go viral. He was not about to let.
He was ready. I liked how he dealt with it.
Yeah, he wasn't gonna get marked out.
Yeah.
On the internet, definitely. He can't let that happen. He can't let that happen.
Got at him in his own little way.
All right, Ruger.
Yeah. Big Rudog.
Yo,
what's up with you, man?
Man, you know me, man. You know me, man. I'm just ruling the other side of the pillow, dog.
Okay, my people don't know shit about you, man. My people don't know.
Let's put them up on it.
Who are you, Ruger?
I'm Ruger, man. I'm from Compton. Compton.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? I grew up... Yeah, I went to high school in San Pedro. I stayed in San Pedro.
Okay.
I was back and forth from, you know, right there to the hood, right there. I went to school on Rosecrans. That's where it all started at.
Yeah.
Apartments. You know, my mama grew up in apartments. You know what I'm saying? My people's from apartments.
Yeah.
My folks from apartments. You know, everything in apartments, shit.
Yeah.
Come shit, from the soil.
Yeah, the soil.
Shit,
soil.
Man.
149.
Yeah, that's where it all started at, man.
Okay, and how long you been rhyming? How long you been rapping though? Like,
I've been rapping since like 2014.
Taking it like serious?
Oh no, nah, taking it serious. I've been taking it serious since 2017.
Okay.
Yeah, I've been rapping like on some. Like I'm a rap type shit 2017.
So that's when your first project came out, or when you
2018. Oh yeah, my first project came out 2018. But my first like song came out 2017 when
Man,
I first got out.
When this nigga got the fuck out, dog. Came home from jail and you fucking recorded Letter to Stanford.
Back on Stanford
in the hood. Nigga, this nigga went fucking crazy. Went crazy. If that's like a introduction to the rap game, that's how you do it.
Yeah.
That's how you fucking do it, nigga. Bar for bar for bar, just going crazy on that shit.
Was that some shit you wrote in jail or you?
Yeah, I wrote it in jail. I was talking to Lil Zo. That what song was that came out? T Grizzly, that first day out.
Okay.
Yeah, it just came out.
Okay.
Shit, I used to be on the phone and shit. So he like, get on YouTube and look up that first day out. It's by T Grizzly. Like, do some shit like that. Like, on some shit.
Yeah.
So I went and just listened to it. It was like, all right, for sure.
Yeah.
I think I had like a month to the house, a few weeks to the house. Nah, not even that. Probably like a week to the house or something.
Yeah.
I was sure when that came, like when he told me about that shit.
Mm-hmm.
Nigga just got to like picturing being out, just what a nigga was gonna do, shit.
Mm-hmm.
Fresh up out of prison, shit. Back hanging on Stanford.
Yeah.
I just put that shit together. That's how I started that motherfucker. That's just what it was.
I feel you. I remember that. I didn't think that was like your first shit though. I thought I thought you had was rapping before you went to the penitentiary. Yeah. You just was like getting back at it.
That shit was a hell of an introduction.
I told the homies in 2015. The same year I left, I told the homies I could rap though. Like I down there could rap. You feel me? Like I didn't try to be from my boy YK. Like he used to be rapping all in high school and shit. Like
yeah.
But I used to be like the homie. I used to just go right there and just be, you know, just bigging it. Like I wasn't even on that shit.
Though. Had all that in him the whole time.
Yeah,
the
nigga. Like he used to be telling me to do that shit. All so that nigga did that shit one day. I told the homies, told Weed and shit. Like I down there could rap. Wrote some shit. Told him. Like, damn, that shit damn ain't hard. Like, I remember the first time, like a couple times, but one of them times I told the homie I could rap. I told him I could rap. I rap for some nigga from, he was Hood Rich or something in Atlanta. Like Hood Rich Rip. I was rapping for him same night, went to jail and shit. Bayou Black, rest in peace, on the real. Went to jail, ended up getting out. End up coming back still on that, like, shit, I'm gonna do it again. Like, from, I mean, not do it again, but you know, I'm a rap, like, yeah. Fucking around. I end up, shit, whatever. I end up getting shot that year. Kept fucking around. End up going to the pen.
Remember taking to the hospital, followed to the hospital.
On the real, this nigga shit right here, man. For one for this nigga, man.
I strapped up there to the front, man. Crazy part when we got to the hospital. He like, bro, is it bad? I'm looking like, nah, you good. Go ahead, man. I ain't wanna, yo, you can't tell a nigga. You know what I mean? You don't want nobody to panic. And the nigga was so calm and collect. Like,
he wasn't
panicking or nothing. Nigga stood up and walked into the hospital. Drove off. And this day I called Weed, like, hey, man, you know, we got shot. Whoa. Tell his peoples. That was it. It's all right.
Damn, man. God has got your back like a motherfucker, man.
Yeah, for sure. Because that's where I got shot at, in the back.
Right.
Wow.
Straight through. Right.
And people right get paralyzed. Right over my spine. Like, right.
And went straight through the left, like right over the spine, and right out the right.
People don't survive shit like that without getting paralyzed. I mean, this nigga like, blessed, dog. That's blessed.
That's why I think, man, that's why I be for sure. When you supposed to go, you go. No matter where you get shot, wherever at, you out of here.
That was your time.
Yeah. Like, man, it's crazy out here. All right, so when did you get your first rap money? When did you get your first money out the game from rapping?
Money was when I dropped that first tape, that For the Love of Money.
Okay.
For the Love of Money.
Yeah, that was
I dropped that. That was my first tape I put together. Me and my bro, shit, me and the homies, my bro.
Yeah.
Put that motherfucker together, dropped it.
Yeah.
And then shit, yeah, a couple months came by, shit, bro came up to me like, shit, it ain't much, but you shit. You
got a little paper.
Yeah, you
got. That's what's up,
got
bro.
A couple dollars up in there.
That's
like, shit,
what's
all
up, man. Any money off of that shit is always beautiful. I like to know the first time a nigga get some money off the rapping. You know what I'm saying? Like, really, like, pay me, like, type shit.
That's what make you focus. Sometimes it can be troubling being focused until that money comes, because you got bills, you got other shit you got to do and handle. Sure. And then if rap ain't paying you, kind of hard to stay on that course.
Yeah. Like, what about the shows now? When did you start getting your shows? And right when you dropped that,
I remember setting up a show a minute ago with him, man. We had so much fucking fun.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Did I rap on stage? Yeah, me and Milano rapped on stage. Mm-hmm. I took off my shirt and shit, wilding and shit, man. Bro looked at me. It was a nice size event, right? Bobo looked at me, he said, yeah, he a little bit too big for this event. We got to go bigger now. Man, the nigga puts on the show, man.
Hey, man, I be hearing bitches. I've been hearing bitches talking about you, Ruger, man. You got fans, bro.
Yeah.
You like a sex symbol out here, man. I ain't trying to be like putting extras on it, man. When bitches say something to me about it, like, I got to just get the niggas, they, you know.
That's a sign.
Like, when bitches say, you know what I'm saying?
You need bitches on your team. Bitches really buy shit.
They fuck with the whole little, you know, the dog. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Shit.
Plus, I make that kind of music and shit.
This was the first person I seen make a hat go viral. You got the dog hats or whatever that is. Man, them motherfuckers, everybody got one.
Wow.
And everybody to get their Rosecrans shirt on or some shit like that in the dog hat.
Oh, okay.
You feel what I'm saying?
You
and
got
they
a little
post
thing going.
And they post it.
Oh, that's what's up, my nigga.
Got a brand, man.
You got influence.
They post it. And then now he has the shirts.
Yeah.
The dog talk shirts. So, you know, just make sure they got that. So what that should say?
Too many goats, not enough dogs, man. Everybody trying to be a goat, man.
Yeah.
That's a classic quote right there. That's
okay.
Quote.
Okay.
Shit, nigga, pushing, man. Got it. You know what I'm saying? Just trying to
Yeah.
Everybody gotta do their thing, man. Shit, that's my thing. That's what I'm going with. That merch.
Yeah, that seemed like the whole thing. Like, you gotta have merch to accompany your, it's a good thing though. To have merch, like a good merch release with whatever you doing, you know what I'm saying?
Sure, for sure. And like with how we coming with the whole Rosecrans thing, we coming as a whole, so like we coming with a bag. You know what I'm saying? So how we trying to come is like it's different. It's not like we needing the label for everything they got. You know what I'm saying?
We
coming together and do this, like, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
More of, you know what I'm saying? We need each other type of thing more than just like we need y'all, like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I feel
that's
it.
A better way to, you know.
I feel the self-sufficiency element over there like a motherfucker, man.
Yeah, that's what make niggas more powerful.
Yeah, I see it, man. You know, it seems super strong, man. Like, it's a lot of niggas with talent, man.
Definitely.
It just make it super strong, man.
Something in the water.
Yeah,
so much talent in our section, man. It's crazy, dog.
Yeah, everybody
doing bread, yo.
Yeah.
So, like, all right, so your next move, what you got coming up? What's your next?
I'm about to drop this little EP.
Okay.
A little 4-song EP.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm going to get something like that out real quick.
It seems like that's the good thing to do now is the EP joint. Like, niggas ain't got attention span for albums and shit. Like,
feed the streets a little something.
Yeah.
I'm going to feed them something, but I'm going to drop a I guess like a double tape type thing, but not really. Okay. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, it's gonna be some shit like that though. I'm gonna drop though. But
okay, now let me ask you this, man. Where do you see your sound? How do you define your sound right now? Influences?
Like,
cause I know you bombed it.
Yeah, I don't really sound like nobody. Like who do I listen to or something? Like, you know,
he really got his own.
Because I really don't sound like nobody. Like, I really don't have.
Can't
that.
Really compare it.
Like, right. I didn't mean that to sound negative. Or
No. Yeah, it didn't sound negative. I was really trying to think of like an answer for it, but it really like is no category for it. And that's like where the dog talk come in.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, cause it's like it ain't really no category. Like, people will label it shit talking, like, you know, that type of.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Right. I notice your flow is. I don't want you to get offended or nothing.
No.
But when I listen to you, man, I be thinking of like Blue Bucks Clan a little bit, like the type of shit that they be talking in there. Not the same, but like y'all niggas is talking shit like to make niggas hot, like, you know what I'm saying?
I ain't really heard no Blue Bucks Clan song.
They really kick like more like the like player, like, you know, like designer and all like that type of stuff.
Yeah, you know, and then I was gonna point out some shit that yours is a little bit more aggressive, what you saying. Like, you more like it's more it's like, you know, well, they don't talk about gunplay that much. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But it's in there though. It's in there. And when I think about what I'm saying, it's like the designer talk, the shit talking, the age bracket that y'all in, you know what I'm saying? And the bitches. That's, you know, when I'm thinking about it.
How many people is in the, is that a group?
It's like a group. You ain't never heard they shit?
Yeah, I know who they are, but I've never heard like a really sat down and heard a song. I know exactly who they are because a lot of people were saying about the Draco shit that they stole his style.
Yeah, they stole Draco's style.
I don't know if that's true.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's true or not, but that's what I heard, you know what I mean? So I ain't really never sat down and really like.
Two of them.
Okay, like. don't know, man. I'm old and I'm looking at the game, so I don't have the same perspective as y'all. You know what I'm saying? Right. So I'm, you know, all I could do is listen to a bunch of music and just be like, I feel the same type of
vibe or something.
Energy, like y'all gonna have the same type of fans and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, I see you in they lane, like y'all all competing for the same people. You know what I'm saying? And okay, let me frame the question like this. What beats do you like to rap over? Are you certain type of beats, or are you open to all kind of beats?
I rap on all kind of beats.
It used to be kind of like a Detroit style.
Lately,
he's been like real versatile lately. Like,
okay.
When I first started, I used to listen to a lot of Detroit. Like,
yeah. Okay, do you feel like you was influenced by them?
Yeah.
Do you think that's negative or positive?
It wasn't negative.
Right.
It influenced me to rap.
Wow.
I mean, like, it was really my homies, though, like, for real. The homies, the ones that was telling me I could rap, you feel me? They was just telling me, like, what's more to be on, like,
this
type of shit, like, you feel me? This shit going crazy, you feel me? I was just fresh out the pen, like.
Right,
so, like, when I left, I was listening to, like, RJ, you feel me? Like,
right.
He was still dropping and shit, like, but you know, they was just telling me what niggas was listening to now. Niggas was listening to this type of shit, Detroit, what niggas was on. Mm-hmm.
Right.
A nigga got to listen to that and was like, all right, like, I can get with this type of shit, like.
Yeah.
So it was, you know, so it was Detroit, but it was, like, really more the homies, you feel me?
Right. I could sense them, too. Yeah, I seen how they was on it, too.
That's how I just turned my own, you know, just turned that into my, what we was doing, our own little shit, like.
Right.
Made the shit bumping.
Right.
Yeah, that's all the homies listen to. For sure.
Now, I noticed y'all using different slang. I'm old. I'm a little slow and shit. But y'all be saying chicken for money, right?
Chicken talk. Chicken check.
Yeah. Where that originate from?
Chicken came from.
Man, that's a good question.
Is that y'all word? Y'all made that up?
That's a good question.
That might be a Detroit term for real. That might be something they were saying in the Detroit shit for real. I ain't gonna lie.
Mm.
It was very popular with the homies.
It was popular with the homies.
Homie would walk up and say, chicken check. I mean, show your money. Show them racks, nigga.
Yeah.
Big bank, take a little.
I like
bank.
That word. I like how.
If it wasn't that, it was Baby Black for sure.
Yeah, he always said.
I was like how you was using that in the rhymes, bro. Like, yeah, I liked it that. I had never heard that before.
Yeah.
But maybe I don't listen to enough. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But
I only
heard Skrilla and you say that.
Yeah.
Now, maybe all the rest of everybody else say that, but as far as in rhymes, I ain't.
Shit, that's us now.
Yeah, man.
Yes, sir.
I wanted to let you know that I peeped that, and I, you know, you might want to build on that. That was catching my ear out of. You
know. Yeah, for sure.
Definitely.
Yeah. I be telling niggas, man, like, I don't know if niggas be paying attention to that, but I feel like that be like a driving force behind movements is when niggas have words this
That stand out to them, that sticks to them.
This for them.
Yeah.
Just like how
Mozzie do a lot of that, E-40 do a lot of that type of.
But just like how
where you from?
What's his name? Bobby Smurda now.
Okay.
You know, I think that was a lot of their edge in the beginning, was when they smutty and saying all that shit, you know, and having their words and that, you know what I'm saying? So you should think about that type of shit, like, you know.
Yeah, it's like that. It's the dog, nigga.
Yeah. Yeah, I like the.
Everybody that walk up to me say that, that shit be making me like. That's what had me like really like
started
really like doing that shit. I really just said it on a song, just on some like, I really was the dog for the music that I was making, but most of that music I was making got fucked up in that computer that I was talking about.
Right.
So I never released the music where I was really like saying that I was the dog, because it was like the ratchet shit.
Right.
I never dropped it. Right. So when I did the Bont and P mix, I just like, since it was like that type of beat where it kind of broke down before I rap, I just said that shit like it's the dog, nigga. And that's my new shit.
So now it's
and
just,
that shit just like stuck with everybody. Like that shit just became a thing. Like, but even though I was already calling it, nobody really heard the real reason why I was calling myself the dog for real.
Right, right.
They just heard that right there, and then it just kind of picked up. So it was like, fuck it, shit. They still caught on either way. But I never even got a chance to drop that ratchet shit. Shit. A couple homies got it, cause you know, like homegirls and shit, cause I sent it out on my phone. But
yeah,
it wasn't never got a chance so I can get it mixed or nothing like that. It just is what it is.
Yeah.
So shit, but yeah.
That's what creative. That's what creative motherfuckers do. Make up some shit and other motherfuckers get caught up by it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He wasn't even doing trying.
Right. Right. That's what being creative is.
Yo, you so creative. You know what I'm saying? That's saying a lot, man. That's saying a lot. But I picked up on that you should have y'all saying chicken like that. That really
chicken talk.
Yeah.
Shit, check.
Creativity is
New visuals. You got some visuals coming out anytime soon? New.
Yeah, I got a couple.
Cause I just seen a new video. You is that out right now?
No, it ain't out yet. I got that. It's called Back and Forth. Yeah, it ain't out yet, but I'm about to drop it soon, man. I just been, you know,
I feel it.
Hyping it up, man. Trying to get the people ready for that shit, man. It's hot shit for real.
Yeah.
I ain't even ready for this, like this little new flow. Back and Forth got a cold flow too, but this like this next little wave of shit, I ain't.
So you experimenting out there with shit, huh? Trying new shit.
He can record himself now.
Yeah. Oh, you got your own shit?
Yeah. Hell so yeah. I've been recording myself a lot lately and shit.
When you get shit like that and you get to recording yourself in the studio at home and you can work, that shit takes you to.
I'm already knowing.
Show for sure.
Yeah.
I still fuck around the studio a little bit. You know, I go.
But you home base now.
For sure.
Did that increase your productivity, your output?
Yeah, hell yeah. I be trying all different kind of beats. Cause I just be fucking around. I got the time to fuck around. It ain't like, all right, I got an 8-hour session, so I'm in there trying to get certain, you know,
right.
I ain't really got that time, free time to like, you know, just be doing it. But nigga be at the house, shit is what it is. I do whatever the fuck I want. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Wake up, tap my grill, shit, wash my face, and I just get to rapping and shit. I ain't nothing.
Damn.
Just get the fucking
Dedication, man.
On some real shit right now, you say like if you know, you had everything you needed, you know, how long it take you to do an album? Like if you just closed off and locked down in the crib and just worked straight through, how long it take you to 10 quality joints ready to go?
Probably like a few days,
a few days.
Yeah, so
working.
I feel you. How much? So you got projects just stacked up, chilling, or you just?
Yeah, hell yeah, I got some shit.
I feel you, man.
Got a big catalog for sure.
Okay, now what about like in your visuals going forward? Like, do you have any like different concepts you thinking about trying, experimental shit, or just ideas that you want to get out there? You know,
visuals.
Yeah,
shit. I'm going for movies and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
Acting everything out, like just, you know what I'm saying? Not just really like so much just rapping at the camera. So no more like.
So you thinking about putting together the mini film joint?
Yeah, like just really doing, you know what I'm
on
saying?
On some directing type shit, and you playing some of the parts and shit?
Like some shit like that, you know what I'm saying? Which, yeah. Like still rapping though, like, but just like doing a little more of like acting shit out
there. Right,
like,
right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Just like doing it like that, like bringing that shit to life more. Like,
yeah.
What I'm saying, because I be saying some shit like, but Some of that shit probably be going over people's heads and shit like that.
I think the game is demanding that now. The niggas do more visual, like short film pieces and type shit to bring the ideas.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? A little creative shit, man.
Sure, for sure. And then I got the cameraman for it. Shout out my nigga Johnny, man. Shit.
White Bus.
My nigga White Bus, man. That nigga like, you know.
Yeah.
He really like a, you know, he bring that shit to life. Like, the real, he got that movie type.
Okay, so y'all got a real camera motherfucker on that.
Shit, deck. He been down. He shot my first music video when I got out the pen. He was already fucking with the homies. He shot that back on Stanford.
Johnny been around for a little minute.
Around for a while, shit.
I used to go to my boy John Boy house, right? Be over there late night and shit. And that's when I came across Johnny. And I don't know what it was, man. Me and Johnny vibe just hitting off, you know what I mean? I'm in the music shit behind the scenes and shit, trying to make shit popping. But at the same time, I was rapping a little bit too. I brought Johnny to the hood, man, and nigga, it was rocking ever since then, man. Everybody started fucking with the nigga, man.
Brought him in and got him into the fold.
Yeah. But the thing was, his work spoke for him.
Right.
His creative spoke for him, man. And see, he kind of been like the Rosecrans cameraman ever since.
Right.
Ever since, man, we really fuck with Johnny. And
Johnny Hart.
Yeah. The Boogaloo be making shit happen, man. You, I feel you, my nigga.
We be working, dog.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Okay. Let me think. I want to, man. Listen. All right. I seen you do a show with Boogie. How many? You did a few shows with Westside Boogie.
I did one show. That's how I put it.
One show.
Okay. That was like 2018.
Not that observatory.
Yeah, observatory. Say that word. Yeah, was at the observatory. Anaheim.
I saw.
It was a big crowd.
I saw you. Yeah. You made it rain on the crowd.
Threw some money and shit.
Okay, was that like a regular practice or just for that moment right there?
Shit, like that was like a thing. We was throwing money everywhere.
We was
like going to like pool parties. We was throwing money.
Niggas just throwing ones. Ain't no strippers around. Yeah. We just throwing money. Niggas just shining. You know what I mean? We had Rosecrans. We trying to build up Rosecrans.
That's where my first show started. Actually, like the homies, we really kind of like was paying. Like kind of like, cause we was going to Crazy Girls every Monday.
Yeah.
And we was going to this club called the Sky Cabaret in Carson. That ended up turning into. They end up turning that into what's the name? Because that shit got so bracken.
It was there.
What's that shit called? It was a big. It ended up turning into a big strip club.
It's a strip club now, but it was over there in Carson.
And it gets shut down. But
was it Deja Vu? Or
no, not Deja Vu. No. But they ended up getting turned into something. I can't think of it. It was a big name though. Man, they got them out of town and all that. But we used to go there every Sunday, and we used to turn that shit up though, like to the point to where like. The strippers, when we walked in, like the strippers used to walk up to all of us and be popping it, and the bitches would be coming to me like, "Ruger, can I come on stage with you this time? You said I can come on stage last time." Like, I'm like, "Yeah, I got you." Like, for sure. Like, I'm just popping it, and that shit just got crazy. We was up there every weekend.
Just wanted to perform.
Just performing, throwing money, crazy girls throwing money.
Yeah, I think about it, man. They probably should have gave us some money for that
show.
Shit.
For sure.
Y'all niggas did.
Cause look, first
you know,
time,
you know
that shit wasn't nothing. It was a hole in the wall.
You know y'all niggas was doing the BMF formula. That's
going to be more crazy.
So look, the first time when I get with the nigga at the club, right?
Yeah.
He let us in. He told me, "I'm gonna let your partners in. For $10.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? The second time, but the first time he seen how many people that we brought, and I guess he felt like he missed out on somebody. The second time, the nigga charged a dub to get that motherfucker. But they would give us a free bottle and a free table. You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
And it had some little things, like kind of like some little glass things.
Yeah,
some little glass rooms. Little player type shit.
We used to always get one of them.
Yeah. So
we be in there doing it up, have all the strippers in there, all the birds
come through, all the homies perform. You know what I mean?
Then we start even having like the part functions up there though. That's when it started going crazy.
Yeah, Man, that nigga should have paid us.
Hey, man, I noticed
RJ ended up performing 1 year up in there with us. We all performed. RJ came up in there performed. Joe Moses came in there before. Like, we really turned that shit up, going crazy in that motherfucker. Like, they really should have paid us on Vaughn.
Hell yeah.
We turned that shit up.
I noticed that nigga's name is popping out there. Motherfuckers, a lot of people know about Rosecrans like that.
Definitely.
With a lot of respect on it though, like, so yeah, I've been doing.
Should have been going good. For, you know what I'm saying? Nigga been at it for a long time. Niggas just
put that work in.
I even when the homies for, you know, when it all first started, shit, we, everybody was there. You know what I'm saying? When it first started with the Rosecrans, with the R, like.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember all this shit, but I saw it all develop, man.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Man, I remember when the the homies came up. I think it was Tate and Zoe. Like, hey, look, we about to get a label started. Like, oh yeah, this time I'm rapping around a little bit. Like, I'm like, yeah, what's up? What's the name of it? The nigga say, Stacks and Straps. I said, what? And look at our homie Nut that passed away.
Right.
He used to talk about a record label, and that was the name that he wanted to name it, right? Uh-huh. So the homies tried to honor that name, but I'm like, man, we need something else smoother than that.
Yeah.
You know how niggas have to sit on the stairs and Temptations to figure out a name. That's what niggas have to do. Niggas come back. I think it was the next day. So it was like Rosecrans. I'm like, yeah. And then there was a lady that used to sell like Rosecrans merch and shit.
Yeah.
But we was really from Rosecrans. We really didn't, you know what I mean? Live and died and sweat and tears and all this shit for Rosecrans. So nigga, shit, we Rosecrans. And we just took it over. Just took that shit over.
Hey, man, I thought it was only right, man. When I first heard it, I was like, okay.
I wasn't even rapping
it. I thought, man, I'm going to keep it a buck. When I looked at, you know, when I saw Nipsey them, basically.
Yeah,
I was like, it's only right.
It's only right.
Hey, man, it's not even, you know.
Yeah,
it's a simple approach.
Yeah,
it's valid.
These
the right individuals to do it.
Well deserved. Shit, it is what it is.
We the ones that represented. We the ones that represented Rosecrans.
I was like, that was valid.
We
was the ones putting on for the Rosecrans. So hell yeah,
that's us. You know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah, that's us.
Put a billboard up on that motherfucker.
Yeah. I remember when niggas had that video over there, and G Weed was pressing. What's his name? What's up, boy? Problem.
Yeah. Oh yeah. When Quick and Problem came.
Yeah.
We had a little meeting because they tried to name their mixtape Rosecrans. They were like, God damn, what's up?
And then put
that
up thing? A billboard and shit. Right.
Yeah. So I think they never, I don't know if they even followed through with the shit after the meeting.
They had it was a project.
Yeah, it was a project.
And they just came and went.
Yeah, like, I didn't really hear too much about it.
They didn't do no more after that. They didn't push it no more.
Yeah, so I think.
Oh, it didn't come up.
It came out. It just didn't put. No it just push. Let it go. I don't
think they want to cut us.
Whoever gonna listen to it. We ain't making no more videos. We ain't
no okay. promotion. Yeah, shit.
So, I don't think they wanted nothing to do with it after the meeting.
Yeah.
What was that?
Niggas.
They came to the apartments quick and probably.
Was he out? He was out. He wasn't out for that.
I don't think so. No. I don't think.
Why?
So, nigga, they came and niggas just kind of just told them, niggas, like, bro, like, Rosecrans is us. We really got homies in jail for this
that
shit.
Was
you
funny.
Know what I mean? That's that, you know, and cases they got on Rosecrans shirts and shit, you know what I mean? And, bro, no.
It was a trap.
We just need. And then we came up with, like, look, well, you know, we can sell our merch or, you know, we can open up for somebody or some shit or open up for him or some shit. You know, just put this address up in there.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Shit got squashed. They drove away. We ain't heard shit else about it.
Yeah.
That's just facts. We ain't heard shit else about it.
Yeah. That's crazy, man.
Yeah.
All right, man. I appreciate it, man. Ruger in the building.
Yes, sir.
Damn, I had something else to ask you too, man. All right. let's get into the reader listener emails. We about almost 2 hours in, Ruger. Oh man, I had a train of thought and niggas said something and took me off of it.
Gotta start writing it down, boss man.
But it had developed while we was talking type shit, you know. But I had to wait for a nigga to complete a thought. And then, you know, that shit.
The pen right there.
Yeah, you right. Yeah. All right. Let's do a reader listener email. Get it done. You know, people send me emails and ask questions and want game and shit, different scenarios and shit. Chime in on it if you want to and whatnot. All right. Reader listener email. All right. A nigga from Arizona writes to Boss Mac. He say, Boss Mac, young nigga out here, fresh out of college, out here teaching. Things been good. I got the crib and the whip. Plus, on top of teaching, I be hustling on the side, so I'm good. I got two bitches in rotation. One bitch is a teacher bitch. Another bitch is an office manager. I have no monogamous agreements with my bitches yet. My teacher bitch just got a new house. So the other day, the bitch wanted me to help her move some shit out of storage with her and some of her homegirls. When I arrived to help this bitch, it was me, three other bitches, and two other niggas. Now, I didn't trip. I just made a mental note of these niggas. They was weak niggas in my opinion, so I just ignored the niggas and interacted with the bitches. It knocked out the little bit of moving. Her homegirls was on my dick. But we finished up, they ordered pizzas. I got a text from my other bitch and I was out. The next day I spoke to my teacher bitch. I asked, was she fucking both of those niggas? She said they was friend zone niggas. And she just needed the manpower. So, Boss Mac, was that some bullshit that the bitch put me in? Should I continue fucking with that bitch? That shit seemed hella weird. What's your thoughts?
Why is he mad that he got another?
You don't sweat that, though. I ain't nothing to be sweating. You mad because the bitch had... It's two other bitches and two other niggas right there.
It ain't his main bitch, is it? No, he got two bitches,
yeah,
right?
Man, I ain't sweating now.
He say he felt, you know, in the presence of other niggas that she was dealing with, you know.
Oh, man, you ain't.
You can't be worried about that type of shit, huh?
Oh, man.
I can't. But he probably worried because if they friend zone niggas, that means they done got at her before. And got friend zoned.
He said.
That's what friend zone means.
Yeah, I mean, they was niggas that they wanted to fuck that she was using.
They could have been some friends or something from back in the day that didn't try or something. Ain't no telling. They could have been anybody.
Yeah, they definitely tried. That's why it's a friend zone.
To be caring about.
She said they was friend zone niggas, so, you know.
You got two bitches
in rotation.
I'm trying
to figure out why he cared, though. It's not his main bitch. He got another bitch in rotation. Yeah. Like, why is he even? Why does he care so much? That's what I'm trying to figure out. It's not your bitch.
I'm trying to save all of them now.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
It's not your bitch. Like,
you know, niggas be having like, you know how niggas be fucking and try not to be caring, but really care.
You could care, but I mean, just don't. You know what it is. What it is, though.
Right. It sound like his feelings
different
involved.
Type of care.
Yeah,
his feelings involved.
Yeah, gotta learn how to work this shit.
You gotta take your feelings and put
them. The way I see that is, you know, everybody got somebody else.
Definitely. Facts of life.
You know what I mean? And as long as you getting respected, that's the key. Getting respected, fuck them other niggas. You know what I'm saying?
You can't be stressing or shit like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, man. Put on. And then the other bitches that was there, you know, put on for them too. Like, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You said the bitch was feeling you.
Yeah,
you
so.
The bitch was feeling you.
Might as well fuck her.
Yeah, shit. If you.
You probably
feeling hurt about the two niggas, you might fuck her friend.
Maybe that'll make you feel better.
Fuck it off. Go, risk it all, shit.
Yeah.
We talking fuck. The dog talk, yo. Yeah. So you know what the answer gonna be, nigga.
Fuck it all up.
You feel me?
Dog, how would you have handled that? You'd have been there and seen the other two niggas and then you'd have flirted with the bitches heavy, you'd have went. You'd have just looked at it, just seen the situation, what it was, and just been like, whatever.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't have really been sweating this shit. I might have asked the bitch, like, man, what's up with them? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What's up with that? Like, who is them niggas? But once she told me that, then shit is just weird. It is. But I probably would have asked some niggas who they was my damn self, for real.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep it true. She probably 9 times out of 10, shit, a bitch ain't gonna do no shit like that. She ain't gonna bring me around no niggas. She know, you know.
Yeah, man. Well, you know, you like, a certain type of nigga though. Like these, this is a teacher.
Different. Yeah. I done brought myself. I done brought myself into it. He has. You know, nigga, he got the right to ask. You know, what I'm saying, like, what was that? You know, who are you? You didn't tell me nothing about it. Who is that?
Yeah.
But after that, you know, you let that go.
Yeah. Okay. All right, man. Don't worry about no bullshit, man. Just keep being that nigga.
You know what I mean?
That's all you got to do.
Keep shining, man. Keep teaching the youth, man.
Okay, now here's a more difficult email. A nigga from San Francisco writes the Ball Smack. He say, Ball Smack, I'm out here working. And getting it out the mud. One of my jobs is personal trainer at an upscale gym. I maintain not fucking any of the bitches that come through to keep down the drama. However, recently a nigga has been in the hunt for a condo to rent. One wealthy older white bitch that comes through here heard about it and offered me a spot. Some fly shit with a view in downtown Frisco where the rent is astronomical. Bitch is gonna let me have it for $2,500 a month. Rent is usually $5,000 to $6,000 a month. The twist is the bitch want me to hang out with her like once a month. What are your thoughts on this type of shit?
Like, what? Yes. The fuck is wrong with that nigga? Yes. Once a month?
Once a month.
For this fly ass shit we got
four
going on.
4 weeks
right
in a month.
Man, you got that 30 baby.
Days.
Deal.
One day.
Nigga, deal. It's a no brainer. Deal. Yes. I do not mind.
You wouldn't feel leery about that, no type of
man,
way.
Come on, man.
One day out the month, that's easy.
Come on, man.
That's easy. I'll do it.
Come on, man.
Yeah.
My mama would tell me to do that.
Right. Yeah, damn right I'll do it. Call me a gigolo, whatever you want, nigga.
Hey, man.
Be living good.
I've heard stories about that, man, about niggas having exceptional cribs like that.
Uh-huh.
And then it was like...
Exceptional cribs.
and the key was a secret bitch like that, like an old bitch that was secretly loved him over here somewhere that hooked it up like that. I heard a couple of times like that. Hey, man, you got to, you know what I'm saying? Make it count. You got to make it count, bro. Make it count, man.
End of your business.
You got to make it count, bro. Whatever you doing to project that image, make it count.
Yeah.
Make it count. make it count. let me think of some more shit for Ruger, man, because I feel like I forgot some shit, man. Wait a minute, it almost came back to me. Have you done any other podcasts, bro?
Her shit was like more of like a show. It was like a show, really, nah. It's like my first time doing a podcast.
Okay, that's what's up. I'm glad to be, to bring this to you, man.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, man.
It's cool. I like that this is my first podcast, you know what I mean?
Man, I hope it was a positive experience for you, man. I'm trying to flow and glow for you, man, you know.
Yeah.
Perhaps niggas come back and vibe with us more, you know what I'm saying? Because it's always shit going on.
Yeah, for sure.
Always something to talk about.
It's plenty of shit. You feel me? Like,
yeah.
You know, it's plenty of shit. What did you go to prison for? If you don't mind me asking.
Robbery.
Robbery. And your prison experience, how long was it?
They gave me 2 years. I did 19 months.
How was it for you? How was the experience?
Prison was like, the whole experience was like, how they say like it make or break you, like type of deal. Like,
right.
That shit made a nigga like, you know.
Right.
Taught a nigga a lot.
Right.
I came out a whole nother person for real.
Right.
Yeah. What's
the what's the number one like good thing you took away from it? You think?
Prison.
Yeah.
To not ever come back.
That.
That shit just turned me out to like be patient though, like, you know, observe shit, think.
Mm-hmm.
Be patient, like, you know.
Right.
That's what, shit like that.
Patience is key.
Yeah.
One thing I was fascinated about jail is how jail is a place where everybody who breaks rules end up, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But then when you get there and you in there, the rules are super serious. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about like amongst the inmates, you know, and the seriousness of the rules. And it's like, to me, it seemed like discipline went to another level. Like,
yeah,
it's like you out here, you was wild, you know what I'm saying? But in there, you forced, even if you wild, to be have a certain level of discipline. Like,
yeah, that's for sure.
Like, you go mind somebody.
Like, I knew a lot of this shit. I ain't never been DP, like, you feel me, like in the jail and none of that type of shit. Because a lot of this shit I already knew from the streets, but
right,
that shit still do teach you like some structure though, like some sense of structure, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's a weird thing.
Yeah. Try to tighten up on your shit,
and you gotta keep it
everything
active.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Exactly.
If you turn keep something down, go get to the streets.
Right.
You turn that shit down.
It's a trip how that all works automatically. It's like, it's pure.
Yeah.
Sure, for sure.
It's pure and shit.
It's a little difference. Like, you can be on the streets and you can be like a family guy, kind of like I really been stared away from that shit, doing good.
Right.
But once you go to jail, you know, you're from that gang.
Right.
And no matter what you doing on the outside here, niggas gonna need that in there. So it's like you gotta turn on the gladiator mode when you get in that motherfucker.
Exactly.
And you do the best thing I can tell a motherfucker when they go to jail, don't walk up in there on some extra rah-rah shit. Just be calm, collected to yourself. Because when you walk in there with that extra rah-rah shit, somebody's gonna test you. And if you're not always like that, Nigga gonna be able to see your weakness.
Always gonna be somebody around there on that. Yeah, like that.
They gonna be able to see your weakness. You know what I'm saying? It's like a shark when you walk in that motherfucker. Right. Or you even make your bed up. Niggas like, where you from? Oh, yeah, you from where? Oh, yeah, well, cool, man. You got like, I got like four fades in the back. You know what I mean? We're gonna set that up. We're gonna make your bed and we'll get to that. You know what I mean? So,
yeah. For sure.
Gladiator school, you know?
Yeah.
Gladiator school.
Yeah, sure, sure. Yeah. I'm fascinated off of that, man. Like, I was fascinated by that when I went in there. Like, I was like, wow, this is like.
Game banking at an all time high.
To me, it represented reality.
Mm hmm.
Like, the way I looked at it, I was like, this is reality.
Right.
What's happening outside is like a faded version of this.
Yeah.
This is really what's really happening right here.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And that was, you know.
Yeah.
The smallest shit to get you poked. You know what I mean? The smallest.
I felt the possibility, you know.
Yeah.
Not, it wasn't like I was worried about these things, but I became aware, like, oh, you could die in here.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
You could die.
You can lose your motherfucking life and not make it up out of here.
Or I could be forced to do some shit where I'm gonna be in here maybe 4 or 5 more years.
Especially in the pen.
Exactly. That shit be crazy as soon as you in there. You against your will. It's a whole nother life. It's like you were underground somewhere. That's really live.
Living
right here.
That life right
and
there,
these motherfuckers
that.
We got life and shit are forgot about by their homies and all this shit. It's like you were in a whole nother fairy tale land somewhere or some shit. And when you get out, that shit kind of seemed like just like all that shit was like a dream or some shit like that.
Like when you
but
first
you
go
really,
in,
it really happened.
It really happened.
When you first go like in that motherfucker, you steady talking about, yeah, when I was on the streets, I was doing this, doing that. Then you getting in that motherfucker, you in there for some months. That shit get to being over with, nigga get to going, you know, nigga go to the pen, do his thing.
Yeah, program.
You just get to being in jail, just doing all that. Then nigga get out. And then shit, little shit niggas do be like, damn, my nigga in the pen used to be doing that woo doo woo woo. They be like, damn, why you steady bringing up them jail stories? Like, shit, that's what I've been doing for 19 months. Like, you feel me? It's like,
right,
that's what
right,
nigga
right.
had to like shake out. But shit, like, right. Damn, you remind me of some shit the nigga what he used to be doing. Shit, like, oh, my, the nigga wake up to the nigga every fucking day.
Yeah.
Oh, my, I know when a nigga mad. I know when he this. I know when he that. Like, I know everything about him, shit.
Yeah.
Nigga next to him every day, shit.
Yeah.
That shit, bro. Especially, like, when you in that, even, like, when you on a, you know, yard with, like, in the dorms, I mean, the cells and shit like that. I didn't been right there, too, but I was right there I ended up going down to the 1 yard, though, like, I ain't had no high points or nothing like that, like level 2 points type shit.
Mm-hmm.
Ended up on a 3-4 a little bit, like, cause it was like level 2 points, then they overrided me. I went to the 1 yard. But on the 1 yard, like, it's in the dorms, like, you feel me? So you really, like, gonna be with everybody, like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
right,
you really
right,
seeing
right.
everybody, like, ain't in the cell where you going back to this one person every day, like, even that type of shit, like, you know, when he mad, sad, or like, you feel me? I did 4 months in reception in the cell. And that shit was like that. Like, you know, when this nigga, everything, like.
That's wild, man.
Every emotion the nigga go through, you feel me? You gonna catch on to all that shit. Like, but he like living with a nigga in a little ass box.
Yeah. Yeah, that's fascinating shit, man. It seemed like you become a specialist at reading human behavior. Like,
That's that type of shit a nigga learn. You know, just.
So how does that.
Observing.
How does that play out for you right now, though? Do you feel like that give you advantage in a lot of situations where you feel like you could read motherfuckers better than other people?
Yeah, for sure. Read, yeah, situations, body language, hell yeah, when shit ain't right. Yeah.
Nah.
Hell yeah.
You know,
even
the
gut instinct, even, you know?
Right.
All that type of shit.
You know, the most craziest thing about jail is, like, when you gangbanging, you black.
Right.
And when you black in jail, you will always be outnumbered by Mexicans.
Yeah,
that's just what it is. It's gonna
and
be
white.
More, and whites, you feel what I'm saying? And
right.
And these motherfuckers, that's once your enemies are Crips and all this shit, y'all up in that motherfucking, y'all all y'all got in that motherfucker. You know what I mean? Y'all cool in this motherfucker. Y'all doing the spread and all this whole other shit. But when you get out of jail,
they go back.
Yeah, like that's your enemy now. But in there, that motherfucker probably stopped the Mexican from stabbing you, or you know, watched your back while you working out or some shit. You know what I mean? Like, yeah,
right?
That should be crazy, dog. A lot of motherfuckers up in that bitch stressing over what they baby mama doing and the girl doing. They arguing on the phone, arguing on the phone and shit. But the thing is, though, when you get in that motherfucker, you gotta start gelling. You gotta program. You gotta cut all that shit, the outside shit, off. You know, I mean, you can talk to your family, your mom, and all that shit, but you all that always thinking about what the fuck. No, you gotta focus on making about this motherfucker.
So you don't fuck your head.
You feel what I'm saying?
Right,
you
right,
can't stress
right.
about all that shit right now. All that shit is gonna do is just eat you alive, nigga.
Right.
You focus on getting
you
out
need
this
to be on point.
You need to be on point, dog.
Right. That's a fascinating thing, man.
Sure.
Yeah, man. Shit, man. I hope niggas get some game from that, man. Like a motherfucker. Well, Ruger, I appreciate you coming out. We got like
for sure, man.
Little 2 hours in, man.
Appreciate you having me, dog.
Yeah, man. We gotta, you know, do it again. I won't forget my questions and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Get it up.
Oh, some old right. nigga shit, man. Man. But we gotta do a photo shoot though.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
Thank you for coming out. The Top Mac Nigga Show is a Boss Mac Industries production.